Good morning, friends. So we are done with our chapter on polynomials, and I hope you all have revised all the formulae. Have you? I hope you all have revised the formulae, all the expansion we have done so far. So today we'll write down the formulae first, all of them, and then get back to the chapter. So we have the expansion first. X plus y the whole square equal to x square plus 2xy plus y square. X minus y the whole square is x square minus 2xy plus y square. Then we have x minus y into x plus y as x square minus y square. Then we have x plus a into x plus b equal to x square plus a plus b x plus a b. Now here the plus in this bracket or this bracket may change, and accordingly the plus minus here changes. So there are four different formulas: x plus a into x plus b, x plus a into x minus b, x minus a into x plus b, and x minus a into x minus b, which will give us four formula, but we are not doing it here, but in the practice sums we'll see to it. Then we went to the square of trinomials. We did binomials, and square of a trinomial was x square plus y square plus z square plus 2 into bracket xy plus yz plus zx. Now this variable can be ABC, PQR, or 2x, 2y, 3z, whatever. This is only the basic variable, right? Then after the square we move to the cube. So x plus y the whole cube is equal to x cube plus y cube plus 3xy into bracket x plus y. X minus y the whole cube is x cube minus y cube minus 3xy into bracket x minus 1. Okay, then now I'm writing the expansion, so I'll follow the order. X plus y into x square minus xy plus y square gives me x cube plus y cube. So this is the multiplication, it gives me this, and the factorization of this will give me this. Also x minus y, x square plus xy plus y square is x cube minus y cube. Okay, and then we have the multiplication of x plus y plus z into x square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz minus zx equal to x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz. Okay, so all this formulae you can see in the previous lecture. I have derived all this formulae. All this formula derived in the previous lectures. So going from the left to the right gives you the expansion, and going from the right to the left gives you the factorization. So this special form it is given factorizes to this form. So these are the equations, all of the equations, all of the identities mentioned in the book. So now we start with the factorization part. So we have got so many lectures. I have had slowly in each lecture I have derived for you each formula. Okay, now how do you make use of it? So here there are two terms. This is the binomial x plus y, but not necessarily the sum is in a binomial. Suppose the sum given to you is say 3p minus 4q and you have to square it. Okay, so the numbers here, you can see the coefficients, the variables can change, but the form will not change. So this is the form here. Here your x relates to 3p and your y relates to 4q. Can you see that? So these are identities in which these numbers, the variables can change. but their form will basically not change. The form remains the same. So if I want to find 3p minus 4 to the whole square, I have to use this formula where the x is equal to 3p and the y is equal to 4p. So what is the equation then? The expansion is 3p the whole square minus 2 into 3p into 4q plus 4q the whole square, and this gives me 9p square. 2 3s are 6, 6 4s are 24, pq plus 16q square, right? This is the expansion. So now what you can see here, and basically what you have to understand now, the chapter is fully done, but the question you are going to be asked here is factorize. Now when you will sit to factorize, you will have to know all these identities first. All this expansion you should know. So first, looking at the sum, you will have to find out which part of the identity. So which identity will you use? So you can look at the sum here. Suppose I give you factorize this. The question asks this: factorize 9p square minus 24pq plus 16q square. So you have to find the factors of this. So you can do by which method? Splitting the middle term also. You can use here, it's a quadratic equation. It's not a quadratic equation in the first place. It has got two terms with a middle term in between. So you can use it, but it makes it very complex. So now comes the real part, and the real part is, since all this is done, you have to first look at the question, and the first thing you have to figure out is which identity to use. Now before you can make use of this identity, you have to memorize all this identity with their plus and minus sign. So even if you make a mistake of one sign, then your answers will not be correct. Right? So the first things we have done, the formulae. In every lecture, I have taken the trouble to write the formula each and every time. So you should be having a formula sheet of this sort, and you have to learn all this formula. Okay? Learn means not cram it up. We have found out how this formula comes, so learn means you have to understand and memorize this. You don't have to cram this. So once you understand the working, you will then eventually get to your answer. So this part actually here, this one, the formula, the two factors that we find for this one is actually what? This is called splitting the middle term. This formula basically is called splitting the middle term. You can see here, the coefficient of x square is 1. And this is AB. So 1 into AB is AB. Okay, you got a number here. Now you have to find two factors such that the sum is A plus B the middle term and the multiplication is the last term. So this is which method? We did, I guess, in the lecture number 2 or 3, splitting the middle term. So what is the only complex part in this chapter is, once you have memorized all this formula, just by looking at the question, you should know which identity to use. For example, say factorize 125 aq minus 216. So you have to just factorize this. Now for factorization, you should know which identity to use. So this is a perfect cube. Even this is a perfect cube. If you try, you can see, you can write it as 5a the whole cube minus 6q. Now as soon as you write this 5a the whole cube minus 6q, your attention shifts to which part? To this part, a cube minus b cube. So this sum is also a cube minus b cube. So the factor is a minus b into a square. So 5a square is 25a square plus xy, x into y, 6 5 is 30. So 30a plus 6 square, so 36. So these are the factors of this. So the only thing you have to do here is what? Once you see the question, yes, when you figure out the question, that this is the question. If this is the question, you have to use this identity. If this is the question, you have to use this identity. So at once you should be able to understand which identity is to be used. So that is the only thing where you have to do a lot of thinking. A lot of thinking means, if you know this formula very well, you will exactly know which formula to use. So we have gone through all the lectures very slowly, understanding each formula one by one. But in the exam, they are not going to mention the identity. So that is where your thinking part comes in. You will look at the sum and find out which identity to use and how to directly get the answer. So this identities are supposed to make your work easier for you. Now let us take an example. Okay, so look at the sum given to you on the board. 27 minus 125b cube minus 135b plus 225b square. So there are four terms which are given here. Okay, so looking at the formula, you try to figure out which will be the terms that we are supposed to use. So 27 you can see is a perfect cube. 3 cube is 27. So you have to also try to identify what are the numbers. So this is 3 cube and this is 5b cube. Now what is 135? How can it be written? So we can write it as 3. Okay, what is common in both in 135 and 225? 15 9s and 15 15s are, right? So this is 45 3s are and this 45 5s are. So I should be getting 45b common and inside the bracket 3 minus 5b. Right? The common part. So this is written as now 3 minus 3 and this is 5b. The whole cube, so do not write 5b cube, it is 5b the whole cube, minus 3 into 3 into 5b, 3 minus 5b. So how I have written this, 3 3s are 9, 9 5s are 45. So what am I getting here? You can see what I got here. I got which part? This part. Here x is 3, y is 5b. Okay, so x is 3, y is 5, so check. What I got? 3 cube minus 5b cube minus 3 into 3 into minus 5b, so that is 5b into 3 minus 5b. So, I should get x minus y the whole cube. So, what is my x here? The x is 3 and what is my y? 5b. So, I factorize this sum to 3 minus 5b the whole cube. So I think you're getting the hint of the sum. So I have to factorize this. Now in the exam, the question is mentioned, but the identity is not given. So you have to figure out which identity is supposed to be used, right? Let us see one more sum. Say, factorize 27x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 9xyz. So again you have to find out which identity is this. So this looks similar to the last one here. So let us try writing it down. 27x cube can be written as 3x the whole cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3 into 3x into y into z. Did you follow this? So this is x cube plus y cube plus z cube. The cube of the first three minus 3 into a into b into c. 3xyz. So because it's been written in this form, this is the factorization. So what will the factorization now be? It will be 3x plus y plus z. Then squaring this. So 9x square plus y square plus z square minus x into y. So what is 3x into 3y? 3xy. Then y into z, so minus yz. And then minus 3x into z, so 3xz. So the factorization of this is this. So what you can see here, all these sums can be done using the identity. And again, I repeat, the only part, the first thing, so how do you make this chapter thorough? How you become very good at this chapter? The first thing now, you will have to go through all the lectures again if you need to and first find out how we got these identities. So this formulae have not come by magic. Okay, there is no magic here. There is simple logic only. Remember, when people say that maths is magic, it's not actually magic. maths is simple logic and you can understand this logic very easily. This formulae were derived by mathematicians, but they have shown us how we can also derive them, and it is very easy to do so. So first you understand the formulae, then you will try to remember it. So when you understand how the formula has come, it makes it easier to memorize and remember. So first step is remembering this formulae, and then we go to the exercise. You see the sum, and by looking at the sum, you try to figure out which identity from here will be used to factorize this. So that is the real, what we say, the core of this chapter. That is the real work in the chapter. The only real work in the chapter is understanding the formulae and doing the application, applying this to find out the factors. Then we saw different sums also. Yesterday we found the cube of 104. How did I find the cube of 104? I wrote 100 plus 4 the whole cube, and in place of x I put 100, in place of y I put 4, and I got the answer. Then we have got two more steps is, which we did in the previous lectures. Splitting the middle term was one of them, and the second one was what? For the cubic, by the remainder theorem, we first find the factor, then we do the long division method and find the quotient, then we split the quotient by splitting the middle term and get all the three factors. So this is basically the gist of the lesson, right? Now let us discuss the homework we did yesterday, the sums I left you to prove. So one of yesterday's question was, if x plus y plus z equal to 0, show x cube plus y cube plus z cube is 3xyz. This was a very simple question. If the x plus y plus z equal to 0, you have to show that x cube plus y cube plus z cube is 3xyz. Okay. Now we'll see how we get this. It's a very simple thing. All you have to do is use this identity. Okay, this identity. So the identity we have is x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz equal to x plus y plus z into x square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz minus zx. Okay? What is given to us? It is given x plus y plus z is 0. So this is 0. So I don't need to write this. Why? I'm just copying it down as it is, but it is not needed because 0 into anything is 0. So this should turn out to be 0. So the right hand has become 0. This is the bracket here, but x plus y plus z is 0. So if this is 0, then 0 into anything is 0. So we have x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz, this term equal to 0. So if this is 0, then take it on the other side, then x cube plus y cube plus z cube equal to directly 3xyz. So now if you are told to find, say, 2 cube plus, say 2 cube minus 5 cube plus 3 cube. So, suppose I told you to find this. Now we directly apply this. So you know what is 2 cube? 2 cube is 8. 2 cube is 8. 5 cube is 125. And 3 cube is 27. Okay? So what will your answer be? Minus 125 plus 27 is equal to minus 98. Yes? And minus 98 plus 8 equal to minus 90. So in this question, when we do the answer, by the method we get this. But now what you can see, this is 2, minus 5, 3. So 3 plus 2 is 5, and 5 minus 5 is 0. Means x plus y plus z is 0. Can you see this? What is x? 2. What is z? 3. What is y? Minus 5. If you add x plus y plus z, means 2 plus 3 minus 5, you get 0. Then the answer should be directly 3 into x into y into z, means 3 into 2 into minus 5 into 3. So what do you have here? 3 threes are 9, and minus 5 into 2 is minus 10, and 9 into minus 10 is minus 90. So I find, without finding the values, we can directly get the answer from this identity. Now this was very simple, we could do this, right? But suppose we have got some like say 7 cube plus 8 cube minus 15 cube. So 7 cube is 343, 8 cube is 512, but 15 cube is a very huge cube, right? So here when it is given this type of sum, we don't find the values like this. Without doing, we will know that 7 plus 8 is 15, minus 15 is 0. So x plus y plus z is equal to 0. The answer is directly 3 into 7 into 8 into minus 15. We multiply this and we get the answer. So we get it directly without finding the real values. So this is the application of the last type of the formulae. So you can see here all the sums which are given in the book, all the sums which you have done is nothing but making use of the formulae. So you will be able to do the chapter very easily now. But like I told you, I repeat again, first thing, see how we have derived all the formulae. See how we got the formulae, then memorize them well. Once you have memorized them, you can pick up any sum, look at the identity and factorize it. Now we'll see one more variation of the sum. In yesterday's homework, you had to verify this formula. Now look at this, both this formula. If you see the left side, in both the formula is the same. X cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz. Left side is same. In the right side, this x plus y plus z and x plus y plus z is same. But this part has changed. This has become half into x minus y the whole square plus y minus z the whole square plus z minus x the whole square. Now what you can see here is it is given the verification, means all you have to do is open this bracket, yes, open this bracket, and you will get this answer. Or you can do the reverse, and we will do both of them. First we will do with this one. So what we will do, we will keep the LHS, LHS right, the RHS, I will multiply and divide by 2. So if you followed what step I have done, the two brackets were there. I multiplied by 2 and divide by 2. Because this 2 and 2 get cut, so you get the same thing back. So what I have done again, I have multiplied by 2 and divided by 2, means I am not changing the value. If I would have multiplied by 3 and divided by 3, even then the value would not change. If I would multiply by 5 and divide by 5, even the value would not change. But I have multiplied by 2 and divided by 2. So now this half xyz remains as it is. But what happens, I put into the brackets, so I get 2x square plus 2y square plus 2z square minus 2xy minus 2yz minus 2zx. I put the 2 inside the bracket. And now, only a little bit of rearrangement. 2x square can be written as x square plus x square. So I will write this x square minus 2xy and a y square from here. What I have taken, x square minus 2xy plus y square. Now I will write y square again. Why? Because y square plus y square is 2y square. So there are 2x squares, 2y squares and 2z squares. I will write this as minus 2yz plus z square. Okay, so I have taken a z. And here I have written z square minus 2zx plus x square. So what I have done here, this 2x square is written as x square and x square. 2y square is written as y square and y square. 2z is written as z square and z square. Minus 2x I have brought here. Minus 2yz I have brought here. And minus 2zx I have brought here. So this is what I can do, right? Now, this part remains as it is. Now, x square minus 2xy plus y square is nothing but x minus y the whole square. Plus, y square minus 2yz plus z square will be y minus z the whole square.
and z square minus 2z is plus x square will be z minus x the whole square. Hence we have got the identity.
So you can see here, sometimes to solve the sums are put into different forms. We multiply and divide, or we add and subtract. So this is what mathematics is all about. And this is good for the people who can think differently. So sometimes a sum is simply given, but you have to think differently. How differently? Multiply, divide by 2, or add and subtract by 2, and do the sum. So I will show you one more sum on the board, how we can use to factorize. Okay, so let us see. So now, a different type of sum totally. Let us say we have got x raised to 4. Yes, x raised to 4 minus 7x square y square plus y raised to 4. Now if you look at this sum, and let us say we have to factorize this sum. Okay, we have not done any sort of identity here, raised to the power 4. But what I can do, I can write this as x square the whole square. Why? X square the whole square give me the power 4, because 2 2's are 4. And I can write y square the whole square gives me the power 4. So these two are perfect squares, you can see. Now the middle term is either plus 2x square minus 2x square. So if I write minus 2 into x square into y square, then I get minus 2. So what remains here? Minus 5x square y square. What I have done, I have split the middle term as minus 2 and minus 5. Minus 2 and minus 5 is minus 7. Okay, that is one thing I can do. Or I can put a plus sign here, but if it is plus here, this becomes minus 9, because 2 minus 9 is minus 7. Right? Why I have done this, you will see. Now here, I have got this type of thing, x plus y the whole square. But instead of x plus y, I have got x square and y square. Now instead of x and y, I have got x square and y square. So this becomes x square the whole square, 2 into x square into y square, and y square the whole square. So you can see I have got this pattern now here. So this has become x square plus y square the whole square. And how I can write this 9? I can write it as 3xy the whole square. You notice this. So this term I have broken into plus 2 and minus 9. This became a perfect square like this. And this has become, now you can see this bracket is also whole square and this bracket is a whole square, so it has become a sum like this. So x square minus y square is x minus 1 to x plus y. So here this square minus this square is x square plus y square minus 3xy into x square plus y square plus 3xy. So this is factorized into these two factors. So at the first try this may look, this cannot be solved, cannot be factorized. But now what I did, I added something and subtracted something. I split it up. And how did I split it up? I get 2x square y square as a perfect square, and minus 9 is also a perfect square. So this has become a perfect square, even this has become a perfect square, and I have factorized this. So this is slightly complex, but anyway, it is going to be useful in the examinations. So this may not be a part, a scope of the textbook. This may not be the part of the textbook, but it is good to learn things. So factorization, this identities we have, but you can see the form of the identities can also change. But the basic structure has remained the same. So x plus y in the whole square is x square plus 2xy plus y square. But x square plus y square the whole square becomes x square the whole square plus 2x square y square plus y square the whole square. So if we expand this, what does it become? This becomes x raised to 4. Why? X square into x with x raised to 4 plus 2 x square y square plus y raised to 4. So I had an x raised to 4 and a y raised to 4, both of them, I put a 2x y square in between. But if I put a plus 2 here and then a minus 7, so I should put a minus 9 here. Because 2 minus 9 gives me minus 7, Then this became a perfect square, and even this is a perfect square. So perfect square is x minus y plus y. So this minus this and this plus this is the factorization. So I hope that we are going to end the chapter here, and I will give you some show practice, but I do hope that you understood the whole chapter in detail. Now practice as many sums as you can and get your doubts for me, but practice the maximum sum. Practice makes man perfect, right? So practice a lot of sums and get thorough with these identities, and this chapter will become quite easy for you. So I'm going to end here. Thank you.